The information shared in this episode is not intended to serve as a substitute for mental health services and is only intended to provide education and information to you, the listener. Today, I have the good fortune of sharing space with A. Raymond Johnson, owner and operator of Mountain Zen Shiatsu, located in North Carolina. Raymond is a certified practitioner with the American Organization of Bodywork Therapies of Asia, and he is a licensed massage and bodywork therapist. Since opening his practice in 2013, Raymond has served a wide range of clients while developing a focus on people living with insomnia, chronic pain, stress disorders, trauma, and post-traumatic stress. Raymond teaches workshops at his alma mater, Zen Shiatsu Chicago, and he also produces music under the name Purple Fluorite. His latest album, entitled The Five Movements, is a healing journey of ambient sounds based on the five element theory and chanting the great compassion Dharani. Without further ado, here is my chat with Raymond. Thank you so much for joining the Honeybee Podcast. Today, I have the good fortune of sharing space with Raymond Johnson. Raymond, I'm so excited that you are a part of this conversation. I am looking forward to asking you many questions related to shiatsu because it is my understanding that you are an expert in the field. So thank you again for being here with me.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm so excited to talk to you today and share shiatsu with your listeners.
Awesome. I will tell you that I've heard of the terminology, I've heard of the word shiatsu and never really understood what it sincerely meant. So Raymond, can you please share with me and my listeners, what is shiatsu?
Sure, absolutely. A lot of people, I think, first of all, it's not a dog. I know some people get it mixed up with the shih tzu breed of a dog.
Yes.
Right. It's also not a martial art. I think some people think, is it like taekwondo or something like that? So it's not a fighting or a kung fu type style either. Some people have heard it in the context of massage. So I think most people sort of think of it as like the shiatsu setting on the massage chair or someone who might actually do shiatsu massage. It is a form of body work. It does involve touching the body. And shiatsu just literally means finger pressure. So it's about using your hands and finger pressure on the body to sort of produce a response, a healing response in the receiver. So shiatsu was originally called thousands of years ago, ama. And it sort of emerged as sort of a folk medicine, like on the battlefield or in the farm fields. Like people realized hey, if you push on this part of my body, like this part of my back feels good. Or if you push on this part of my back, then this thing feels better. So it just kind of developed as a sort of what the people did for each other because they were out in these remote areas and weren't, a lot of doctors or medicine out. It was all sort of herbalist and sort of those indigenous ways of healing that we read about. And so shiatsu kind of came up around that same time. And then what happened is that China invaded Korea and then Japan. And when they came to Japan, what happens is people stay behind and there becomes a cultural exchange. And so China had been doing acupuncture for many, hundreds of years at that point. And they came to Japan and they're like, hey, this is how we treat the body. We use acupuncture. And then they pulled out a map of all the channels that they use to stick needles in. And the people in Japan are like, wow, that's crazy. We do thing with our body and we use these channels. And they pulled out the ama map and it was the same map of the body. So these two different cultures had basically drawn the same energy map of the body independently of each other.
Super cool.
Yeah. And so ama was taught to, they started to integrate that into acupuncture school. So if you wanted to become an acupuncturist, you would learn to use your hands and work the channels with your hands first before you would ever pick up a needle. So what I do is I essentially kind of doing acupuncture with my hands and without a needle. So I am touching the body. A lot of it does kind of feel similar to massage. It feels nice the same way massage does. Muscles release, fascia releases, things like that. But what I'm doing is sort of working all the energy and the fluid this body. So the fluid in the fascia, the fluid that in your blood, the fluid in your skin, things like that. So you feel a lot of warmth happening as I work. And that's sort of the energy you feel sort of working down the body and send the body that I generate with my hands. But what I always like to tell people is that even though there are these sort of effects you're feeling, for me, what I love about shiatsu is that I'm getting your body into this relaxed state where the nervous system just calms very, very down. And your body then starts to kick in all of the self-healing mechanisms that we're born with. Hmm. So all of the healing that happens in my office is my clients healing themselves.
Wow.
But I just create a space for them to get into that place where they can do that, because we have so few opportunities in our daily life where we can get into that deeply relaxed, quiet, safe space. And I think when you add someone there, there's also the shared connection and the shared breath and consciousness. And I think that also helps kind of get the body into a deeper, relaxed state too. Because, you know, you feel like there's someone else here. I'm not alone. I don't have to be on this high alert. You know, like that sort of those lizard brain messages and things like that. So I really love it. It's before I came to shiatsu, I worked in law firms and I was a freelance writer and I did a lot of sitting in offices and sitting in chairs. And I like this work because I'm on my feet and I'm moving my body, and it's about paying attention to my body as much as paying attention to the body of the receiver I'm working with, and having these sort of personal connections, you know, that happen in the space and during the treatment, which is a lot different from my work before.
You know, Raymond, I love how you describe the history of shiatsu and the cultural exchange that occurred. And I also am very mindful and appreciative of your identification that the person who's receiving this shiatsu massage is actually healing themselves. And then they have the benefit of enhanced healing because you're in the room with them providing this touch. And so it makes me think, you know, it makes me think about something called co-regulation. When we are attuned and in sync with someone else, there's this really beautiful attachment and bonding and healing that occurs on a physiological level. So it's neat to know that that sort of experience is amplified and enhanced in the realm that you provide. And so then I get curious to know if you're able to speak more about what makes touch a healing and powerful thing from your experience.
I've been in practice for about 5 years and I'm only just scratching the surface on that sort of basic notion of touch. And I have been studying some with Michael Diagro, and that sort of, he does shiatsu, but he does a lot of things. He's based in Michigan and is very well known in the shiatsu community. And he is kind of a geek and he likes to just basically study every touch modality and sort of figure out what it is about it and why it works. Mm-hmm. And that ultimately why they all work, and it's just because they include touch. Like the touch is the medicine. Mm. It actually doesn't really matter like how you do it. Method of touch is like, you know, the speed, the pressure, the country it comes from, the music you're playing, the way you do it. That's really just boils down to kind of personal preference. And that's important because if you find some, you need to find someone that you can connect and get to that space with. Right. So I'm not saying that that stuff doesn't matter, but it's not the medicine, if that mm-hmm. makes sense. So I think that with touch, I think it's so interesting you're talking about that co-regulation, because, you know, if I put my hand on someone and then I may be moving with their breath, but then I also sort of audibly breathe, then we both naturally very quickly will sync up, right?
Yes.
And that happens in the room. I'm sure you've seen that with your clients. You might be sitting in the room and you suddenly sink your breath together. And that can be a powerful experience when you're sitting, you know, 2 chairs, 3 feet away from each other. Mm-hmm. So when you're doing it and there's actual the physical connection and an energy exchange, it's just the same thing, but it's more. I think it just starts to reach other parts of the system. It starts to kind of, I think what I like about it is it also helps us ground ourselves in our body. I think a lot of us, if not most all of us, are very dissociated from our body for the most part. We're afraid of moving it. We're very rigid. We don't want to look silly. We don't want to do this. We don't want to draw attention. We have a lot of cultural messages that I think keep us rigid, keep us not touching each other or not knowing how to touch each other in a way that's respectful and safe. And I think in some ways that's why my work is also, there's kind of an added layer that I think my work is more powerful in part because culturally speaking, we don't have a lot of everyday touch.
Yes.
So I think would be plenty of room for shiatsu as a healing modality in a culture where there was a lot of safe, respectful, consenting touch. But I think where we're at right now, because we're so lacking of that, I think people coming from, there is an extra kind of layer of that's added to the medicine as well.
And so then I get curious about something that I've read on your website, Mountain Zen Shiatsu, which I will include in the show notes so people can learn more about you and your practice. You created an article that was about post-traumatic stress disorder. And
yes.
I find there to be a tremendous amount of value in talk therapy. I think that there are many healing aspects that come from sitting in a room with someone, co-regulating with them, falling into synchronized breath with them, and processing their trauma experience in a therapeutic way. And I won't get into all the nuts and bolts for the sake of this conversation. And I know that there are people out there who are not the biggest fan or buy into talk therapy. They just simply, for whatever reason, personal preference or prior history of it not being effective for them, they don't want anything to do with it. So to that end, I feel like, and I know and believe that your being a part of this conversation will be helpful to that person, because now they may be aware that there's additional ways to heal physiologically and mentally, emotionally, and so forth from trauma without going in to see a therapist or a psychologist. So to that end, can you please speak to how shiatsu massage is helpful with healing aspects related to trauma?
Absolutely. Absolutely. So I've mentioned that shiatsu is based on these maps of the body that follow energy channels. And so these energy channels are named after different organs and organ functions, and there's different associations with each of these. So what I love about this holistic model of seeing the body, what I like about it is that it incorporates functions like digestion, elimination, and blood, you know, circulation, but it also includes emotion. Because, you know, we're starting to really realize emotions are energy and emotions are in our body. They're not just in our brain. They're not just out in the world. We feel them in certain places of the body. And so what I loved about seeing this is that, and what I love about this work is that, like, if I have a client that comes in, I ask them, like, how's their sleep? How's their digestion? And sort of how's their week been, like, what's going on emotionally? Because that's how I sort of design a shiatsu treatment, is going to include all those things. So it's not just about, oh, I have frozen shoulder, or, oh, I have a tight low back. It's also, I have a tight low back because I moved out because I broke up with my girlfriend and I'm really stressed out about it, you know? And so my treatment's going to include different things versus the person who comes in who has low back pain because they just got done with like a 5-day road trip. Because there's going to be sort of a different cause mixed in with it. They might have some similar muscular, but the other channels and other parts of the body are going to be affected in different ways. So it will sort of, I shape a whole treatment around that. So I like that people can bring, you know, I'm not a talk therapist. And some people are, my goal is actually, like, if someone gets on the table and they still keep chatting, my goal is kind of always to hit the right combo of points to get them to kind of fall.
Yeah, that's nice.
You know, because, like, and I know some people sort of need to talk a little bit to get point of relaxation. So I also respect that. Like, I respect that some people maybe just need to have, like, 5 minutes of a little bit of chit chat and then they quiet down. And so, you know, I'm listening to them, but I'm like, I'm not telling anecdotes or asking questions. I'm sort of letting the conversation drift down. So, I understand that some people are talkers and some people are dull, but some people who are talkers need time when they're not talking, right? And so what I like about shiatsu is I love talk therapy. I've had three amazing therapists in my life who have done great things and saved my life in various ways and really helped me work through certain issues. but I still had this piece of my body and what was in my body and these sort of bodily reactions that meditation and talk therapy weren't touching. Right. And so that's why I think I moved into that sort of East Asian's way of seeing the body and moved into shiatsu in that sense. Now, when I started to work with my body and realized, oh, I'm dissociated from it. Oh, do you know what dissociation means? I have trauma. I have a lot of trauma. And I was interested in the work in school. I ended up writing a paper, like you kind of had to pick a disease or a disorder and how you would treat it with shiatsu. And I just decided to pick PTSD. So that article is kind of based on the research I did when I was in school. And so it started there. The seed was planted there. But in the past 5 or 6 years since I've been doing this work, it really has, like, I really work with that issue a lot. With trauma and with PTSD. And I'm kind of open. Like, I don't need someone to come in with a doctor saying I've been diagnosed with this. I feel like if someone says, I feel like I have this, I'm like, great, let's work with that. You know, so I am not someone who diagnoses. Does that make sense? Because I'm also not coming at it from a Western
Absolutely.
Point of view.
Right.
So Westerners will say, oh, this person has PTSD. But in my field, I would need to ask some different questions because I might be like, well, this is actually a kidney yin deficiency. Or this is actually a heart chi, whatever. So we have different ways of reading and sort of diagnosing patterns in the body. So I would ask different questions because everyone's anxiety is going to show up differently. Everyone's trauma is going to show up differently. And so my shiatsu treatment is going to be different for them. It's not like I just have the textbook PTSD shiatsu, you know, 1 hour thing that people come in and get. It would be a sort of tailored, not only to what everything that's happened in their life leading up to the day they walk in their office, but also just what's in the room in the moment. So I'm always kind of walk that line that I think we all are, which is like, what is our past and what's everything and habit and experience to hear, but then also what is the present moment, you know?
I love that explanation. Thank you so much. I'm curious to know, like, for the person who likes the more Western approach, talk therapy, cognitive behavior therapy, and the like, could shiatsu massage be a supplement treatment approach in addition to talk therapy?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I think, like I was sort of mentioning, and this is, I think, is in the yoga community, they're realizing too how much emotions are in the body. So sometimes we go to a talk therapy session and you talk all this stuff and it's really great. And then you know how sometimes it feels it's like buzzing on the surface of your body?
Yes.
That would actually be a perfect time to do a body work, like a shiatsu treatment afterwards, because then it would sort of help you, your body kind of metabolize the experience you just had by talking it all out and having it kind of come to the surface. So I think it's a great sort of combination to do the two. I mean, I feel like I did the combination. I just split it over years. Like, I spent a couple decades doing talk therapy and meditation, and now I'm on the bodywork process. But if I had known, I would have been doing them on the same day. Right.
Awesome. Yes. So Raymond, you know, I really appreciate this conversation. It's been a blast for me. I had a chance to feed my hippie parts, my energy parts, my nerdy parts. And so as we wind down, I'm curious to know if you have any advice or any recommendation that you can offer the listener who may not have access to shiatsu massage for their healing, relaxation, and the like.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I do. I actually live someplace kind of remote and I don't have access to getting regular shiatsu myself. So I have to kind of do a lot of it on my own. And there's kind of a main channel that runs up the center of our body. Like if you kind of start at your pubic bone and up through your navel and then up along your sternum and then to that little curvy dip of your collarbone, that area right there has a lot of really amazing, powerful channels. And my favorite things to do is to put one hand, you can put it maybe on the center of your sternum, and then one hand on your belly button, or one a couple inches below, or try it a couple inches above. So those are kind of the four hot spots I kind of hit. So like one's on my chest and then kind of three around my navel. Mm-hmm. And if you kind of can just play with like having your hands resting there, and you don't want to push, like it's not. A lot of people are like, oh, shiatsu is like acupressure. And yeah, but a lot of my touch is actually expansive rather than pushing in. Mm-hmm. So it's about kind of making my hand be really soft and really gentle. And then maybe just kind of taking really slow, deep breaths. You could also like move your hand, take a couple breaths, move it to a slightly different position. But if you're a meditator and you're already doing a deep breathing practice, like adding those two hands on that channel, I think you'll notice some really big effects kind of will start to happen. I do that a lot anytime I'm feeling any anxiety myself, because my anxiety manifests in my chest. And I don't let myself be afraid to touch what's feeling tense or what's feeling. So sometimes I might do even some light tapping to kind of shake things out, you know, and that can be nice. But also just kind of putting a nice soft hand on it and some deep breathing is a really powerful touch experience with ourselves.
I really appreciate that recommendation. That's something that I will practice, because when anxiety shows up for me, it shows up in my stomach. So then to know that there are points there that can receive a gentle touch and allow for that part of my body to relax, that is super, super duper helpful. So thank you for that.
You're welcome.
Raymond, I had a wonderful time. I thank you so much for your expertise, your wisdom, and your knowledge. I hope that you have a wonderful day and that you take good care.
Thank you so much. I so enjoyed this conversation as well. Thank you for having me, Dina.
I had a wonderful time speaking with Raymond. I sincerely appreciate his knowledge, guidance, and expertise in explaining the art of shiatsu massage, including the many ways that the approach is healing and beneficial. To learn more about Raymond Johnson, licensed massage and bodywork therapist, check out the information provided to you in the show notes. Thank you so very much for listening to the Honeybee Podcast. Until next time. Peace.